We will aim for high score through smart learning, optimum utilization of time, and less stress. Today, I'm going to discuss letter for placing an order. So what is a letter for placing an order? It is written to place orders, as the name suggests, mostly in the case of schools, institutes, companies, industry, etc. So first we'll talk about the format. Now format is simple, as in case of writing a letter to the editor. So I have already discussed writing a letter to the editor. I'll give the link of the video and you can have a look at that. So first we have sender's address. After that, you have to leave a line, date, leave a line, and then there is a reference number before the receiver's address. So this is one new addition in this case. What is the reference number and how you have to write it, that I'll be discussing. The reference number is not given in the question, so you have to invent the reference number yourself. So sender's address is given. You write the sender's address. Sender's address means the person who is writing the letter. Leave a line after that, write the date, leave a line after that, give a reference number, leave a line, and then write the receiver's address for with whom you are placing the order. So the placing order letter, it can be addressed to the sales manager, the marketing manager, the proprietor, or messers. This MS stands for messers. What is this again? I'll be discussing. And in case it is already given in the question that write the letter to the director or to the wholesaler or something like that. So obviously you have to use that. After that, after writing the complete receiver's address, then you have to leave a line. You will write the subject, leave a line, and then comes the salutation. Now there should be six things in the format. Now after this, the sixth thing here, it is the complimentary clause. Obviously that will come in the end. So there should be six things in the format to get full marks for the format. So most of the time students, they forget to write the date and the subject because these are not given in the question. So what I ask my students to do is that in one corner of the answer sheet, they can just write this STRSSC. So these are the six things that are required in the format. This is sender's address, then date, receiver's address, then comes the subject, the salutation, and the complimentary clause. So just write in one corner STRSSC. So it is easy to remember, STRSSC. And in case of letter to placing order, this R becomes square. So STR, R square, SSC in case you are writing a letter for placing an order. Now rest of the things, they are the same as you are writing any other official letter. Now after this, there will be explanation for the messers. Now this is short form of messers, MS. It is a plural of Mr. So how it is used is, it is applied only when a company's name has a proper noun in it as the first word, like Messrs. Anil & Company, and not Standard Printers Company. Now Standard, it is not a proper name. So with Standard Printers Company, you cannot use messers. And it is placed before the title of an organization only if that organization consists of group people. The group of people are there. So that means there is no single owner of that shop or that company or industry. The group of people, they are the owners. So in that case, Messrs is used. For example, Messrs Pramod Sharma & Company, or Messrs Vikas & Associates, or Messrs Gunjan Fireworks. So like this, it is then written. Now this thing, it will be given in the question. So in case it is given in the question, then obviously you have to use that. Then I've used the word proprietor. So who is a proprietor? Proprietor is owner of a business or holder of a property. So in case you don't want to write the letter to the sales manager or the marketing manager, you feel that it's not suiting it according to the question, so you can write the proprietor. You can use the word the proprietor. He is the owner of a business or the holder of a property. After that comes the body parts. Now here, body paragraphs, you can write 3 to 4 paragraphs. In the first paragraph, you have to give the reference and the requirement. So references from where you've come to know about them, and requirement, obviously, what is your requirement about your order. And then in reference, you have to also to give the quotation number, like because the quotations are first sent, and then using those quotations, then a supplier is selected with whom the order is placed. So give reference to that. Then In para 2, you have to give the details of the order, specifications and details of the order. Para 3 and 4, it will consist of the payment, discount, transportation, deadlines, other terms and conditions, future business, etc. So after writing these paragraphs, we will leave a line and then there will be complimentary clause. So write yours truly. So it's always suggested that write yours truly. In this way, you won't go wrong. Then name, in case name is given, so you have to use that name. In case name is not given, don't write your name, just write XYZ and the designation. And this will be the complete format. Again, six things are to be there in the format. In case of letter to letter for placing an order, there has to be one additional reference number to be given. Now, what is the procedure? Like I was talking about the reference. So this is what the reference means. In case of a school or a company, then quotations are first asked from all those wholesalers or retailers or factories who are interested in supplying the product to you. So the management or the company board, etc., they go through all the quotations and the supplier is then decided and then order is placed with that supplier. So what does a quotation actually consist of? Quotation, it consists of the price list. So it is the items and the price list. So you compare the quotations of all those who've sent the quotations to you and you find that which is more suitable to you and then you place the order with that company. So therefore, in your letter, you have to cite that with this quotation number, after referring to that, I'm placing an order with you. So reference is important. With the help of the reference number, previous correspondence dealings, they can be referred to or cited. So this is also the use of the reference number. So in case you want a previous, a backdated letter. So if you already have that reference number in the letter, you can easily find that letter. Now we talk about a few useful expressions, how to begin this letter. So with reference to your quotation number, so you have to give this quotation number, you have to invent it on your own. So just make it a point that there's one alphabet in it and then there are a few numbers, a slash is there like this. So reference numbers, they're usually written like this. So dated, whatever is the date. So we would like to place an order for, here comes your item. And we have heard a lot about your business ethics and genuine prices. So write about the company, why you are choosing the company. We too have found it to be satisfactory. So since our requirement is urgent, so you begin whatever is your requirement. Then another way to start is we got your reference from one of our close acquaintances who praised your company for its customer satisfaction and best quality. The price list quoted by you in your quotation number dated this and this is appropriate according to our need. Therefore, we would like to place an order for. So whatever you are ordering. Another way is this refers to your quotation number dated so and so for whatever items. We are pleased to place an order with a company whose customer satisfaction rates the highest or with a company who has maintained the quality at such competitive prices. So the details of the order are as follows. Another way, with reference to the latest catalog sent by you along with the quotation number this, dated this, we are placing the following order. So you can choose any of the format and you can begin your letter. So I've given you four ways. You can choose any, whatever suits according to the question. After that, this is the para 2. In para 2, you have to make a table and you have to give product specifications. You are not to give this heading there. This is just for you because I'm explaining. You, when you write like this, that the details of the order are as follows. So after this, straight away make this table. So now the table, all in the table, all the details should be there. Nothing should be left for the guesswork of the person who is packing your things. So the item that you require, the quantity, size, color, whatever is appropriate, and brand. So whatever is applicable, if in case you feel that another column should be there according to your item, so make another column. Everything, it should be clear. So five things in the items, they are more than enough. Don't go beyond five, otherwise it will become cumbersome. And don't go, keep it less than five or so. So five items, they are more than enough and they are suitable. Now this is one sample letter, which is a vague letter. So after reading this, you'll come to know the importance of making a table in the product letter, because there are many sample letters that are given with where the table is not given. So in paragraph only the requirement is written, but when the requirement is written in the paragraph, it's not that clear. So it is appropriate that you make a paragraph, or sorry, you make a table. So we are pleased to place an order of the following items with your reputed firm. Kindly send 10 bundles of A4 size sheets and 50 full size registers at the above given address. The payment for the same will be made at the time of delivery. Yours truly. So I haven't included the format, this is just the body. Now here you can see 10 bundles of A4 size sheets. So now 10 bundles of how many sheets? It can be 500 sheets, a bundle of 400 sheets also come, a bundle of 100 sheets also come. So 10 bundles of how many sheets? Then A4 size sheets. What type, what is the quality of the sheets that is required? A fine quality, a premium quality, a standard quality. Then there are glossy paper, there's matte paper. So the specifications are not complete and they are not clear. So the person who is packing your product, either the person will send back this letter and will suggest that you give proper detailed specifications, or whatever is in hand of the person, he will pack that and he'll send it to you. So there, that is why a detailed, proper tabular form is required. Then 50 full-size registers. So how many types of registers are there? So you want paperback, you want a hardcover, then how many sheets you want in the register, then what is the quality of paper that you want. So all these things are important. So that is why a vague letter should not be there. Then I talked about the catalog. In case a catalog is sent, then you have to use that catalog. And using a catalog is very easy. Now suppose you have to place an order for the furniture for school, like double-seated desks. So you want 100 of them, and from this catalog, just pick up the number that I want this 103 number. So write the catalog number there. And I prefer that if the letter that you get in your exam, in case it is for the furniture, then rather than writing the size of the furniture, you will have to mention the length and the breadth, then the wood to be used, the quality, and all those things. So it's better that you just give that. From the catalog that you have sent, I am writing based on that catalog. So give the catalog numbers and it will be easy. Then para 3 and 4. So para 3 and 4, it will consist of payment, then discount. It will talk about delivery terms and conditions, timelines, and transportation. So when I'll be discussing a sample letter, there I'll be discussing all these things, how to write them. And then the last concluding line, it will be a line that will tell about your future business with that company. So we look forward to a successful working relationship in the future. So with this, you can close your letter. Now, points to be taken care of. So language used, it should be formal. No casual talk or beating about the bush. So this is very important. This is not an informal letter. So straight to the point. Straight to the point. Avoid flowery language. Do not use too many adjectives. Be polite, plan before writing, and no mistakes in specifications and details of items, as I've already given you an example. So no mistakes in that. Now, let's take an example. So this is your question, that you are Rashmi Puri, Medical Officer of Army Public School, Ambala. As the new session is approaching, the stock of medicines in the school medical room was checked. A few medicines are required for the medical room. Draft a letter placing order for the same, giving your requirement to Ganga Medicos, Mal Road, Ambala. So what is given in the question? The name is given, the designation is given, the address is given. So this becomes the sender's address. Then it's given that new session is approaching and few medicines are required for the medical room, and you have to place an order to Ganga Medicos. Now here it's written to Ganga Medicos, but it's not given that you have to write to the sales manager, the marketing manager, or whatever. So that means you can choose it from your own site. So let's write it. So this is the format. So Army Public School, Ambala. Now date here I've put March 7, 2021, because the question says that as new session is approaching, so therefore you are placing an order. So new session, it begins from 1st of April. So therefore, keeping that gap, so I have written that date. So March 7, you are writing the letter, you are placing an order. This is the reference number. So this reference number is of the letter that you are writing. That means that is going from your side, from the Army Public School side. So that is why I've used this APS, Army Public School. Then M4 and 21 I've used of this year. So you can invent the reference number in any way. But most of the times, reference numbers are written like this only. Then the receiver's address, as it is not given, so I'm using the proprietor, Ganga Medicos, Mal Road, Ambala. So I hope till here it's everything is clear. Then comes the subject. It is purchase order for medicines. Very short and crisp subject. Purchase order for medicines. For medicines, for school, medical room, so that is not required. Purchase order for medicines. Then comes the salutation, sir. Now we begin with the body. So with reference to your quotation number, now this quotation number is the quotation number of Ganga Medicos, the quotation that they've sent to you. So you have to give reference of to their letter. So therefore I've written GM, Ganga Medicos, so any number you can write like this. Dated March 1. So their quotation reached you on March 1. So after going through the quotations that you've received from other suppliers also, you've selected Ganga Medicos and now you are placing an order to them. So therefore, the date on which you are placing order is March 7 and the quotation was sent on March 1. So you write that we are pleased to place an order with one of the renowned wholesalers in the market who are known for the supply of the genuine medicine. So you write about this company. So you write that you are very renowned and you are known in the market for the general medicine. So therefore we are placing an order with you. So the prices quoted by you are also satisfactory. Therefore we are placing an order for the following medicines. So after writing this, you have to make a table now. So this is the table. So you have to remember a few common medicines and their brand names. So just keep these things in mind before going to exam. At least 5 such medicines and their brand names you should know, so that in case it comes in the exam, you're able to write. So you can repeat a brand here, but all the 5 brands should not be same. So even if nothing is coming to your mind, just invent a brand. So Crocin Advance, I've written the common ones that the school medical room has. So 50 strips, Galaxo, Smith Clen, then Levocitrazine, 30 strips, Mankind, Meftal, Spas, 30 strips, Blue Cross, MSET, 40 strips, Cipla, Offlin, 200 mg, 30 strips, Zydus, Cadila. So 5 are enough. Otherwise, it won't look presentable and you will make mistakes. The more things you will write, you will make mistakes. So it's better to stick to 5. Now the next paragraphs, 3rd and 4th paragraphs, where you have to talk about all those details, payment, discounts, and other terms and conditions. So since our new session begins from April 5, 2021, we would appreciate the delivery of the products before March 30. So you've given a deadline. You have given that before this date, you need the product. It is worth mentioning that the expiry date of all the medicines should be more than 1 year. So you have specified that they have to check that all the medicines, or they have an expiry date of more than 1 year. That is, they are not expired and they will not expire within 1 year. Kindly check that all the medicines are packed properly. Any breakage or wrong medicine would not be accepted and paid for. So you again made it your point clear that in case the medicine is not that you have ordered for, you won't be paying and you won't be accepting that medicine. And anything that happens, some spoilage is there, used medicines are there, so you won't be accepting them. Then in the next paragraph, now you talk about the payment and discount and other things. So a check number, you can write any number of ₹10,000 dated, drawn on. So sorry, here it should not be October. So here also it should be March. So drawn on SBI Ambala is enclosed herewith as an advance payment. So here, again, you have to write, if you are mentioning about the check, so you have to write all these things. Check number you will be writing, you'll be writing the amount, you'll be writing the date, and you'll be writing the bank. So it is enclosed herewith as an advance payment. As it is a bulk order, we are expecting a 10% institutional discount above the usual discount of 15%. So you have to ask about the discount also, because the order, it is a bulk order. So kindly send the invoice with the delivery of the products so that rest of the payment, it can be made at the time of delivery. So because you have given advance payment, which is not a full and final payment, so you ask for the bill. That is, send the bill with the delivery of the product so that rest of the payment, it is made at the time of delivery. Then you talk about the transportation, that it may be noted that the transportation charges will be borne by you, and ensure that the delivery is made between 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. during weekdays only. So you've made it clear that when you want the product to reach to you. So it should be between 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. so that there's someone to receive the delivery, and you've written during weekdays, so you don't want it to be on a Sunday. Then your closing line: we look forward to a successful business relationship with you in future too. So if everything goes well, so you've written that we look forward to a successful business relationship with you in future too. Then your complimentary close: yours truly, the name is given, so Rashmi Puri, designation medical officer, write the phone number, because in case there's any query, they can call you. And this enclosure, this is a new thing and this is important. Since you are enclosing a check, so you have to write down below that what is enclosed in this letter. Because in case it is not there, the person will come to know from this enclosure that you had enclosed the check, but now it is not there. So enclosure is a check number. You have to give the number, the amount, the date, and drawn on SBI Ambala. So in case it is a check or a DD, whatever it is, you have to write about that. So I hope all the things are clear. So if you write accordingly, including all these points in your paragraphs, then there's no chance that your marks will be deducted. Marking scheme. This is very important. So in case the letter is of 10 marks, the format will carry 2 marks. And in case the letter is of 5 marks, as it is now after the syllabus has been rationalized, then the format will carry 1 mark. So what a format includes? Again, 6 things: sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject, salutation, and complimentary clause. As I told you, SDR, SSC. But in case of letter for placing an order, one addition is there. You have to write the reference number. Reference number comes after the date. So then it will be R squared. So sender's address, date, reference number, and then receiver's address. After that, the content. So if the letter is of 10 marks, content will be of 5 marks. If the letter is of 5 marks, content will be of 2 marks. And what is included in the content? So these suggested value points, these actually come from CBSE side, that in case of this letter to the student is writing a letter for placing an order, these things should be there in the content. Only then you can award 5 marks. So there should be a reference to the advertisement or an acquaintance from where you've come to know, or the quotation number, whatever reference you want to give. Then information that is to be given is about the item to be ordered, brand name, model name, quantity, etc. Other requirements are discount, mode of payment, delivery date, attachments like DD, etc. So I've talked about check. So attachment means the enclosures. So all these things, they should be there. Only then you will get 5 marks. After that comes your expression. In case the letter, it is of 10 marks, expression will be of 3 marks. In case the letter is of 5 marks, expression will be of 2 marks. So the things that are included in the expression, their grammatical accuracy, appropriate words and spellings, coherence and relevance of ideas, and style. So coherence and relevance of ideas means that while you are writing the letter, it's not that you are writing mode of payment at one point, in one paragraph, and then after that you are talking about discount in the other. So all things, they should be connected. If you're talking about transportation, then talk everything about transportation at one place. So that is coherence and relevance of ideas. Then your vocabulary, you have to use appropriate words, formal language. So all these things, they are checked in expression. This is the most important thing. Now read this very carefully. This is given as such in the CBSE marking scheme. So I have taken this from the CBSE marking scheme. These guidelines, they are given to the examiners who check your exam, 10th also and in plus 2 also. So read this carefully. No marks are to be awarded if only format is given. This is written very clearly in CBSE guidelines. So all those who are telling you that even if you write the format and you don't have time to write rest of the letter, or you don't know how to write rest of the letter, the marks of the format, that is 2 marks in case the letter is of 10 marks and 1 mark in case the letter is of 5 marks, will be awarded. They will not be awarded. So make it a point to write a complete letter. And writing a letter, again, as I've told you, it is not a big deal. Just follow all the steps. And expressions are given to you. You have just to include things. Talk about all the things that I have given you in the sample letter, and there will be no problem. So credit, it should be given to the candidate's creativity in presentation of ideas. Use of both traditional and new format is permitted. However, mixing up of the two is not acceptable. So you follow the new format, that is the left hand side margin rule. Everything should be towards the left hand side. So don't go into this, otherwise your marks will be deducted. So new format is left hand side margin rule. So everything on left hand side. This is very important. So don't be misguided by channels who are telling you that even if you write the format, the time is less, you will be awarded marks. You won't be. In case it happens in some other boards, then I'm not sure, but in CBSE it does not happen. So I hope that everything is clear to you. So that's all for today. Hope all your queries, they are answered. And if they are answered, kindly subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, and share it with as many people as you can. Give it a thumbs up, give it a nice comment so that I also feel encouraged. And till then, we meet next time with a new topic. Goodbye to everyone and happy watching.